taking a close up of the program. Say hi to who's watching on the camera. Say hi.
There's seven people watching.
Look. Thank you. Good evening, everyone, and we welcome you to the 2018 Fairview Christian School Christmas program. We are very excited this evening. The students have been practicing hard, and I know that they are very excited. Today, there wasn't much schoolwork that got done very efficiently anyways. I remember some of the teachers were saying, please, just practice longer, because the students, they're not working real hard today. They are excited, we are excited, because we believe this is going to be a worship service here this morning. If I can read a couple verses from Matthew 2. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east of Jerusalem, saying, where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. Just looking and referencing back to verse 2, saying, where is that king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. That's what we've come here to do here this evening. We have come to worship the worthy name of Jesus. And if anything else happens here this evening but that, this evening has been a waste. Amen? Amen. Jesus is so worthy of our worship here this evening. I am so thankful for what he has done for us by coming to this earth and reconciling us to God. And so this evening is a celebration of what Christ has done for us. And we celebrate it at this time each year. I would invite you to stand up. And we will have a word of prayer, and then we will sing a song, and after that song, or during that song, we will invite the first group to come on up here. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day that you have blessed with. Thank you for the hard work that the students have put into this program. And God, tonight I pray that everything that is said and done here tonight would be to your honor and your glory. Thank you so much, Jesus, for coming to this earth, dying on the cross for our sins, and reconciling us to God. Lord, there is nothing that we could have done, nothing that we could have done to be reconciled to you, but you did so much for us. You sent your son to reconcile us to you. And so we say thank you this evening. Thank you so much for doing that for us. I pray a blessing upon our evening. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. You may be seated. Just a few items of housekeeping. The bathrooms are through that door, and in the unlikely event of an emergency, there is exits 1, 2, 3, and 4 right there, and I hope that you enjoy this evening. We're going to invite kindergarten and first grade, led by Miss Rachel Niska, to come up at this time so you can start making your way, and we will sing a Christmas carol as they come up. So let's sing Joy to the World. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love. Would you give a warm welcome to our first grade and kindergarten class?
Bye. Thank you.
job. Great job, first grade and kindergarten. I'll tell you what, this bunch right here is a talented group. They're going to be playing in between sets. So, Mr. Nolte's group, you can start headed up here while they play. And I told Jared, this guy here did not take any lessons. I said, if I could have half of his talent. I mean, he's a good-looking guy, but he can even play a guitar better than he looks. So enjoy this group as they play in between some sets. Mr. Nolte's group, come on up front.
Even a commoner understands he should come for his treasures of house and land. He shall dine upon summer strawberries and milk and a bedcloth of satin and silk.
And high as a hill his castle shall glow, the light of the shade like jewels below, and everyone knows that the way is done, that's the way that a king should come.
How should a king come?
On a star-filled night into Bethlehem, where the weary woman and the weary man, and the only sound in the cobblestone tree was the shuffle and the ring of the donkey's feet.
And a king lay hid in a virgin's womb, and there were no crowds to see him. Come at last in a barn, in a manger of hay, he came, and God incarnate he lay.
And the angels cried, "Glory, glory to God! Earth was silent, so the heavens rang. glory, glory to God. Men were dumb, so the angels sang, glory, glory to God. Peace on earth, goodwill to men, glory, glory to God. Christ is born in Bethlehem, glory to God, glory in the highest, glory to God, glory in the highest, glory to God.
Written in red. distracted by the lights over here, us talking about stars or these people up here. But I hope you're thinking about Jesus and about that real star that's coming. This last song I thought of, the phrase that sticks out to me is, "His anthem rings through earth and skies, our King and God and sacrifice, hallelujah." And I'm so thankful this Christmas that Jesus paid the price for us, and we don't have to worry about sacrificing and making sacrifice for our sins. So I would like you to join us in this next song, "Beautiful Star of Bethlehem," on verse 3. I'll turn around and tell you when to start.
Thank you.
Mr. Nolt in grades 1 through 5. Wonderful, what a wonderful job. Mr. Nolt, every year, I tell you what, you just do a great job with that elementary choir. Cyrus, raise your hand up there. Wave at everybody out there. Hey, look at that guy right there. Man, he has improved in his singing, man, look at him. Do you remember him a couple years ago, what he was like? What's going on, eh? What are those lights doing up there? And this, you were piping it out, boy. Great job. How about it for Cyrus? And I think that when children sing, Jesus just smiles. How about it? I mean, it just makes me smile. And I just can only imagine how much praise that he receives from the innocent heart of a child. Great job, guys. Band, take it away. This middle school group. You know what, getting middle schoolers to sing can be sometimes a chore. We sang a chapel today, and I looked at my tenors over here. Look at this bunch of them. Smile, give them a great big smile. Hey, come on, they're so obedient. 1, 2, 3, smile. You guys want Chinese food? 1, 2, 3, smile. they better smile when we sing. You watch it. They're gonna be good. They are gonna be good. They are excited. This group right here, they're just fired up. Inside, they're fired up about singing tonight. And so, you just enjoy these guys, all right?
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed. The little Lord Jesus lay down.
You know, I didn't test these things. Emily came to me at the beginning, she said, Jason, I don't really have the strongest hand. I said, oh, it's really easy. You saw him up here tonight. Well, it worked anyways. Makes for good memories, right? Jason gets the ball. I like to have the fun anyways. I knew they were really hard, I just let you guys hold them. Thanks. Noel, if I could have the light.
We continue our celebration by catching up with Ken and his buddies as they do some Christmas shopping. Let's listen in.
Oh,
we gotta get my Christmas tree
off.
Oh,
yeah.
I need PlayStation. Hey, don't all you just love all the celebrations centered around the birth of our Savior? You know, I don't think I personally would ever overdo a secular part of Christmas.
Really, Ken? Really? Just look at you.
What do you got problems?
Hey. I love to reflect back to things that really matter. Do you remember the Old Testament prophet who prophesied about Jesus coming?
Yeah, what was his name? Isaiah or something like that?
Yeah, that's it. I think it was like 700 years before Jesus was born, he was giving him some names or something.
Hmm? What were those names?
They were
Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, what was the last one?
I think it was something like Golden Fleece. No, capital Greek name.
Come on.
teacher sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Great job. But he is a perfect man for the job. Not just anyone can take a group of middle schoolers and help them sing like that. So good job there, Jason, in middle school. Second here. We're going to do something a little bit different this year. We don't normally do this, but as you all know, something good like this, a good production like this, doesn't happen without a lot of good people behind it and a lot of hard work in. So I saw that firsthand this week. I love this time of year. Walk around school and hear lots of students singing, having a good time, praising God. So I'm going to miss that a little bit. First of all, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Arlen King. I'm the new administrator here. I took the place of Mr. Marcus. And so, like I said, good things don't happen without people behind the scenes putting in the hard work. And we have some quality, hard-working teachers here. So we're going to take some time to recognize them tonight. We've been blessed with some dedicated and some long-term staff. Just out of curiosity, today I sat down and I added up years of experience of all the teachers here, and if we add up everyone's experience, it comes out to over 175 years of teaching experience among all the staff. So that is a big blessing and makes a big difference here at school. So we want to show our appreciation to that. Teachers, this may catch you by surprise a little bit. I don't know if you knew about it or not, but as I call your name, you can come up. We have a card, a little gift for you, and you can stand up here on the risers so we can get a good look at you. For the audience, if you want to use the restroom to take a little break, this might be a good time. But teachers, this is one small way we want to thank you for your hard work and dedication. So I have a list here, so I don't forget anyone. We have a good group of first-year teachers this year. We had some changeover from last year. Sometimes when we get new teachers, it can be hard. You're never sure quite how it's going to go. But we've been blessed with a good group. They stepped right in and worked hard. And so to start off, we have Caleb Gaiman. Caleb teaches in the high school. He teaches chemistry and algebra 2. And I'm sure I'm missing a few, but we really appreciate his help. Push-up king right here. And his sister, Camille Gaiman. Camille also teaches in high school. She teaches Spanish, teaches some math, I believe, and helps out where needed. Jansen Knoll. Jansen here tonight? There he is. Jansen Knoll. Jansen teaches 7th and 8th and has stepped right up. He's doing a great job there. While he's coming up, Joanna Petershaw. Joanna teaches in 3rd and 4th. It's been a big help there. Rhonda Petershaw. Disappointed when God called Dan Petersheim elsewhere after the end of last year, but he was kind enough to send his wife back to teach here, so we appreciate that. All right, some second year teachers, Tamara Fox and Ravon Groves. Tamara helps in 7th and 8th and coaches some volleyball. Ravon helps in the high school as well. All right, Melanie Stolzfus has been here 3 years. And while she's coming, Sylvia Keller. Helps out in first grade, and Sylvia is just a wonderful servant around school. She does a lot of hard work. If something needs to be done, she's there doing it, so we really appreciate that. she's coming, Joanna Martin. Joanna helps in fifth and sixth, and it's her fourth year full time. It's not really fair to say it's her fourth year. She's been here forever coaching volleyball, helping with convention. All right, in her fifth year is Jessica Stoltzfus. Jessica's our secretary, and really, she holds the whole operation together, so she's the reason that the lights are on tonight, we have heat, the bills are paid, so we appreciate that. And the crazy one, Jason Fox. Seventh year here, he does maintenance, teaches eighth grade math, coaches basketball, and he has a lot of fun around here. We appreciate that. All right, in her 11th year, Kendra Zimmerman. Is she here tonight? Kendra helps out in first grade. She's faithfully come up here all of these years, so thank you for that. While she comes, in her 12th year, Rachel Miska. Rachel is our first grade teacher. Does an excellent job there. And Pam Whitmer is next. Pam is our second grade teacher, has also been here 12 years, so we appreciate her hard work. All right, the man behind the show tonight, behind the sound and the lights and sirens and everything else that's going on, in his 12th year, Dave Nault. Teacher, and I joke around with him. I call him the head of the IT department. So anything with sound or technology or network or anything like that, Dave has that figured out and has it all together. All right, in his 14th year, I think I have that right, Arlen Horst. School as well. Teaches Algebra 2, Physical Science, Practical Christian Living. I'm sure I'm missing some, but we really appreciate it as well. We also have some volunteers, some good people who come in and donate their time. You don't have to come up front tonight. I'll just mention your name briefly to thank you, and I have some cards for you afterward that you can find me, and I'll give you those. Rachel Brubaker comes in and helps students with reading. Ryan Fox has been coming around and helping out. Appreciate that. Beth Gaiman, Nancy Culp, Dawn Martin helps in the high school. Yvonne Weaver is our art teacher. Appreciate her. She did all the decorating here tonight, so did a great job as always. Jenny Lamb as well helps out with convention and kind of pulls all of that together. Okay, you may notice there are a few people that are still missing up here, and we're going to take some time tonight and recognize three people who have played a huge part in making Fairview what it is today. I think I can safely say Fairview Christian School would not be what it is without the contribution of these three people. We have two teachers here tonight who have been here at Fairview for 25 years. So that means over a quarter of their life, probably more than that, more than their life, they've given to school here. And we didn't want to let that milestone pass by without giving some special recognition tonight. So to you two, when I call your name, show our appreciation in that way. First of all, this lady may be getting older, but she has plenty of energy. There are many mornings she comes in at 7:20 for staff prayer and devotions, and I think she's more awake and has more energy than us, those of us in our 20s. So she comes in and she's alive and awake, and sometimes more than we wish she was, right? But no, she has served here wholeheartedly for 25 years in the younger grades. And I'll just say this, she might not want you to know, but she has worked for, we'll just say, very low pay. She has sacrificed many hours to Fairview Christian School. So, Norma Fox. Secondly, this man has in many ways been the anchor here at FCS, I would say. Many teachers have come and gone, but he has faithfully been here every year for 25 years. And as I thought about it, I said, you know what, many of the favorite parts of Fairview that we enjoy, like the basketball, sports program, singing, convention, he has been a big part in growing and developing that. He has touched many lives over the past 25 years, and many students, I think, would say he made a big difference in their lives. And so there's no way we can thank him for all the many ways he sacrificed and helped develop the school. But this is one small way we want to recognize him and say thank you. So, to a man we all love and respect, Brian Fox. Okay, one more round of applause for this group. Okay, I will just briefly mention the offering yet, and then we will get back to singing. We've been blessed by people's generosity the past few years. You may have noticed we've got some brand new windows on the school we were putting in this summer. We have two new buses, thanks to contributions the last couple of years. We appreciate that. The offering tonight will go toward two different things. going to put a new computer lab in the high school for the seniors. We're in need of new computers. I teach the computer class, and it can be kind of tough trying to teach a class when all you see on the computer screen is loading, 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 loading. So that gets old. So it's time for some new ones. So we're going to upgrade those. And we're also going to renovate some bathrooms around here. If you can briefly picture with me, picture your bathroom at home with me for a second. All right, now picture about 50 boys running through that bathroom about 5 to 10 times a day for about 15 or 20 years, all right? And that's about what our bathrooms look like right now. So they are very beat up and worn down, and so in need of some renovation. So we'll use this offering for renovating the bathrooms on the second floor, and possibly the first floor as well. So thank you for your attention. Board members, if you're ready back there, you can lift the offering, and I'll turn it back over to Jason.
Famous line from my father is, you can get to your wallets better if you're standing, so you might as well stand. And while you're standing, the offering is being lifted. Let's sing Silent Night.
Silent Night.
For though the days are hastening,
dance in the dawn. Puts a kind of a Mennonite in a tough place. We're not known for our dancing. We're kind of like former President President now deceased George H.W. Bush. They joked about his inability to dance at his funeral the other day. But we're kind of in the same way. But I get the feeling, I don't know, maybe not only in the physical world, but in the spiritual world. Yes, when the Savior came to the world, it had to be a time of great sorrow for the angelic realm. But there was also the knowledge that redemption was nigh. And it was a moment, I'm sure there was moments of celebration. And the lyric I want to point out in this song says, "The long night of sin will soon be destroyed. Come to the manger, sing with joy." And tonight, if we can't dance with our feet, Mennonites, let's dance in our hearts and come and dance at the dawn.
Thank you. you don't want to find God, you won't find him. But if you really want to find God and you really want to see the answer that will change your life forever in so many ways you can never imagine possible, accept him into your life. It's amazing. And it doesn't make life all of a sudden just miraculously amazing and everything. But at the same time, it does make it miraculously amazing. So just listen to this song, and I hope you get the message and realize that God is Emmanuel, God with us through every situation.
Credit to Darlene, who put together a very nice PowerPoint for that song. Thank you, Darlene. Fairview Christian School program has to have a touch of Jenny on it. Here's your touch of Jenny.
Tonight, on the Bethlehem Star, we are privileged to listen in to an exclusive interview
Matthew was doing with one of the shepherds that was there on that historic night. Over to you, Matt.
Good afternoon.
Hello, Mike.
I believe you're Mr. Benjamin Shepherd.
Yeah, that's me. Shepherd by name and shepherd by nature.
Can I introduce myself? My name's Matthew. You may have heard of me and my colleagues, Mark, Luke, and John.
Yeah, I know you, yeah.
But we are doing an in-depth profile of Jesus, or the Messiah, as you may know him.
Yeah, I know him as Jesus. What paper did you say you work on?
The Bethlehem Star.
The Bethlehem Star? The wife and I take that, actually.
Oh, really? Well, I believe you were in on the very first moment surrounding the birth of this holy child. Now, I wonder if you could possibly tell me what happened in your own words.
Basically what happened was that me and the lads were abiding in the fields.
Abiding in the fields.
Mind you, I don't abide in these fields sometimes. I mean, they are unabidable fields. I mean, look around you. These are about some of the most unabidable fields I've ever had to abide in.
Yeah, I must abide by that, huh?
Yeah, that's not so funny.
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah, well, me and the lads were abiding in the fields, watching our flocks by night. That's when you have to watch them at night, you know. I mean, some rats even go about that.
Yeah.
Hey, stop that! Get back here!
Now, where were we here, Benjamin?
Me and the lads were abiding in the fields.
Watching our flocks by night, yes. And then, Benjamin, what happened?
Well,
what's for a surprise?
Well, much to our surprise, the angel of the Lord came down.
Oh, that must have been a fantastic experience.
Yeah, well, it made a bit of a break. It was quite a change from just abiding in the fields, you know.
So, how did you know it was the angel of the Lord?
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what the giveaway was, Matthew. It was this ethereal glow that he was emanating.
Mm-hmm.
He was emanating this ethereal glow. And as soon as I saw him emanating this ethereal glow, I said, yup, that's the angel of the Lord.
Halo?
A halo, certainly.
Yeah, what about wings?
Oh, lovely pair of wings, Matthew. You're gossamer and shimmering in the starlight. It was a lovely sight.
What did he say to you, Benjamin?
Yeah, well, he just looked at me and the lads and said, unto ye a child is born, and unto ye a son is given.
Hmm. So, what was your reaction?
Total shock. I mean, me and most of the lads weren't even married at the time. But the angel of the Lord, being the gentleman that he was, went on to explain that he meant
Now, Benjamin, think back and tell me, what was the atmosphere like on this tense, historic night?
The atmosphere in the stable, Matthew, was very, very smelly. I mean, there was all these cows and goats and sheep about, and, you know, they weren't being careful about it being a special occasion. It was just like normal.
Yeah, well, that's an interesting sideline. Now, was the Holy Ghost there?
Hard to say. He's a bit loose of the Holy Ghost. You can scarcely see it.
Yeah.
I mean, mind you, I think he was there in his capacity as Godfather, but I couldn't say I saw him.
No, well, I suppose even if you didn't see him, he was probably there in spirit.
Yeah, sir.
Well, anyways, I gather that later on in the evening, the three wise men came by. Is that so?
Yeah, three wise men arrived. I mean, well, they called themselves wise men. Me and most of that, I'm not so sure. I mean, in they come bearing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I mean, gold, fair enough. You don't know your gold, always got the number. You can always deal with a bit of gold.
Yeah.
But what is a little baby going to deal with frankincense and myrrh? I mean, myrrh is the stuff that girls put behind their ears.
Yeah, well, mind you, not long after that, he was confounding the elders, you know.
Was he confounding the elders?
Oh, yeah.
Stand that, the elders.
That's
being confounded.
That's one thing they can't stand.
Being confounded.
And he was confounding them, you know, left, right, and center with this tremendous knowledge of history, trigonometry, algebra.
I always thought that carpentry was his mainline work.
Yeah, well, that was just one thing he did. That was his little brother, Jimmy, that took over the joint.
He had a brother?
Yeah.
Jimmy, I never heard of him.
You never heard of little Jimmy? Oh, lovely boy. He shunned publicity.
Yeah.
You know, he used to say to Jesus, you save the world, and I'll take care of the built-in covers.
Did he really?
Oh, yeah. He knew his place.
Yeah. I never heard of him. Jimmy the joiner.
Yep, that's him.
Yeah. One thing I always felt very sorry for Jesus about, and that was his having his birthday on Christmas Day.
Yeah,
I mean, that way, we got one lot of presents.
That was a real shame.
It was. Did Jesus ever have any other problems of any kind, you know?
Well, not really. He was a real well-balanced kind
made the whole universe.
Mm-hmm.
And he did it all in 6 days.
Yeah, you must have been hurtling about the place.
Yeah. Did Jesus ever explain why his dad made all of those horrible things? Those nasty things like flies and fleas and stinging spiders and alligators and bubonic plague. I never seen much use for them. They never seemed to do anybody any good.
Yeah, but be fair, it was just his first universe, you know?
Yeah.
And he did do it all in 6 days.
Yeah, a bit of a rush job.
Yeah, 6 days for a universe, you know?
Yeah.
Marvelous. Anyways, and you say flies and fleas, yeah. But be fair, think of all the wonderful things wild kittens and Persian kittens and geraniums and teachers and lovely, wonderful things like that.
Yeah, not a nice thing when you come to think of it. It's just not really gloomy, so.
No. Anyway, thank you very much, Benjamin, indeed, for all of your cooperation.
Not at all.
Really nice talk.
Not at all. Been delighted.
I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll send you a copy of this when I finish it.
Yeah, that would be fantastic, because, you know, you get a bit bored just to buy the field with your flocks, you know.
Yeah, well, there goes your flock. Anyway, yeah, you must. I mean, we're calling it the Gospels, actually.
Yeah, that's a good title, that is.
I think so, too, actually.
Yeah.
I think, in fact, it might be a better seller than the Old Testament.
Yeah, from what you got all the ingredients there. From what you told me, it's an unbelievable story.
Yeah, well, it's got all the stuff in it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? It got adventure, romance, tragedy, and a happy ending.
Yeah, it got the whole lot.
Yeah, well, yes, lovely, indeed. Anyways, I gotta run off and try to get an interview with Pontius Pilate, but I don't know if I will. You see, he's always in the bathroom washing his hands.
What a unique interview. And now we're gonna send it over to Gabriel Lapp, who has some more for you tonight.
Thanks, Dries. Before I introduce this next song, I would just like to give a shout out to Dan Petersheim, who I can honestly say is a Fairview legend. Dan, why don't you stand up? Ladies and gentlemen, give Dan a round of applause. I think I can say with the full support of the Fairview Choir, you have been very greatly missed this year. So, as you listen to this next song, I do hope you enjoy it, but please keep in mind that we don't have Dan's expertise to lead us this year, or last year's basses, or last year's tenors, or last year's wonderful baritones, and we're especially missing Jordan this year. So, with all this in mind, it is my greatest honor to introduce to you the Hallelujah Chorus.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Thank you for being part of this evening. I hope that you were inspired, and if you know Jesus here this evening, you are more excited about him than ever. I told our church on Sunday morning, I said, if there's ever an opportunity for you to share the good news of Jesus Christ, it's around Christmas time. People are generally more receptive than ever in other times of the year. And so take the opportunity this Christmas and boldly proclaim the worthy name of Jesus. Listen to me, the world is searching for answers. Do we believe the answer is in any politician? Say no, please.
No.
The answer is in Jesus Christ. Can we say amen?
Amen.
And that means that if you are a believer here tonight, you have the answer. And I say we need to tell others about Jesus Christ. He has been so good to us. If you are here this evening and you don't know Jesus Christ, he came to this earth for the very purpose of having a relationship with you, because he wanted to spend an eternity in heaven with you. He is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance, and that includes you. He loves you so much that he sent his only begotten Son to this earth to die on a cross for you. Won't you give him your heart this evening if you haven't? I testify to you this evening that it is a wonderful life serving Jesus Christ. Can you say amen? And for an eternity, on top of it, we are going to spend an eternity with Jesus Christ in a place that is perfect. Friends, we are so, so blessed. Thank you again for coming this evening. One more good round of applause for all these young people who did a wonderful job. I'll get off my horse here in a minute and wrap this thing up. This afternoon, I'm just excited about young people that love to sing. This afternoon, or this morning, actually, we sang, and I told you about my tenors, how grim faith, and Thaddeus, he came to me. Now, this doesn't happen at every school, but Thaddeus came to me and said, your tenors, he basically said, your tenors stank. He said, your tenors were really poor this morning. And I was like, that was awesome. I went back to my tenors and said, do you know what Thaddeus said about you then? I said, he basically said, no, I said, listen to me, you guys got to amp it up. And that came from a high schooler. That's a blessing that these high schoolers love to sing. And so I just bless you high schoolers for putting your heart into it. Not every young person in the world loves to sing about Jesus, but you guys do, and that's a wonderful blessing. If you could turn on the lights back there, and everybody would stand to their feet, I would like to invite Matthew Everly, pastor here, local pastor, also an alumni of Fairview Christian School. He is from the Shiloh congregation, right down here at 5th, between 4th and 5th, to lead us in the closing prayer. And after the closing prayer, this gym is actually rented tomorrow evening, and so you stay here. We want you to stay here and fellowship, but there will be guys coming around and picking up the chairs. That doesn't mean that we want you to leave. We just don't want to be here till 1 o'clock cleaning up everything. Sorry about that, guys. You're going to have to clean up my mess, but Matthew, I believe, would you close us with a word of prayer?
Let's pray. Father, what an awesome privilege we have as your children to be able to call you Abba, Father. And Lord, as we enter this Christmas season, when we celebrate the birth of your Son, the joy that it brings to the world, the peace, Father, may we never lose sight of the next part, is when Jesus willingly laid himself down on the cross to die so that we can have eternal life. And Father, tonight, as the children, the young people sang, I got a taste of heaven, of what it's going to be like to be around your throne and to meet you face to face for the first time. And Father, may we live in that. May we share that joy. May we share that peace with all that we come in contact with this Christmas season. Bless each one of these young people that share of their gifts and talents, Lord. Use them in an incredible way. Father, I just pray too that you would bless this school here and the work that they are doing in the hearts and the lives of these young people and the children as well. Father, I just pray a prayer of blessing upon each one as they travel. Protect them. Keep them in your care. We ask